Hey everybody, welcome to the New Jersey Craft Beer Review, Episode 6. This week, it's 1871 Barley Wine by Dark City Brewing Company. I'm Chris Swenderman, along with my esteemed colleagues, Chris Nucci, Dan Tantillo, and Frank Serto. So Frank, what do we have this week?
So this is Dark City's Barley Wine. So 1871 references the year Asbury Park was founded. So Dark City's Asbury Park. So it's going to be, you know, you're going to hear, see notes of smooth caramel, toffee, some dark fruit. But the biggest thing about barley wine is the alcohol content. It's a higher alcohol content. This one's 9.5. So, you may smell a little, grape, light apple, maybe grass in there.
This may be,
but you see it pours dark. Like a reddish mahogany, right. Kind of, you know.
It's maybe the young one in me, but I don't think I've ever had a barley wine before.
Oh, nice.
Actually, make two of us.
I really?
Don't think I have either.
Okay, how about that?
Cool. Yeah, I've had a bunch. They're not my favorite style, but, you know, this is, we're in the dead of winter, and this is huge. What'd you say? It's 9.6?
9.6.
So this is, you know, the ultimate sipper of beers. I mean, there's beers that even go higher, you
of course.
Know, 12, yeah. 18. Yep. I don't know what the highest you could possibly have is. But yeah, so barley wine, that big, you know, bold winter beer, I would say. Is what it is. And you can see Dark City. So you said 1871.
1871 is the year Asbury was founded.
And Dark City is an old nickname for Asbury Park.
There you go. Yeah. Learning a lot today.
They were the first brewery in Asbury Park, and they opened like a year ago. But already, I think there's one or two other new ones that have popped up. Right. You know, and there's a lot down in that area.
Yeah.
Already,
but the whole area is growing in general, so it makes for, you know, even more events to go down to Asbury for. It's a great city in general. So.
Yeah.
And they talk about that too, how the culture down there is a lot of artists. You know, people are expressing themselves. So that's kind of their take on beer they want to make. Really interesting stuff that's expressive. So let's check out the color. And like you said, you know, it's kind of like a toffee brown.
Yeah.
Little
white.
Reddish.
Yep.
Not too much head, which is expected in the higher alcohol beer. It usually dissipates
quickly. Yeah.
Can't hold on to the head. So give it a smell.
Definitely a strong smell.
Definitely
get a strong smell off the bat.
It has like a fruity, I would say grapey kind of smell.
Yeah. Grapey. Dark fruit. You can smell the alcohol off of it.
Right away.
A little bit of alcohol heat.
Yep.
A little caramel, a little toffee, you know, a little sweetness going on.
But yep.
Cheers, guys.
Cheers.
First time. Barley wine?
Yeah.
Right, exactly.
Rhyming and everything.
It's good. Coffee.
Definitely different.
You know, little coffee taste.
I taste the coffee. Yeah. It's got a malty flavor.
Very malty.
Yep.
Almost like, you guys ever go to Outback Steakhouse? I think you do that brown bread. When you start
yes.
The pumpernickel.
The pumpernickel bread. Yeah. Pumpernickel, yep.
So Outback bread.
Never thought that would be coming up in one of these beer reviews. I don't know how to react to it, to be honest.
It's pretty good. It's not, you really don't taste the alcohol.
No.
Right?
Like no.
It's hidden pretty well.
Yep.
But it is strong, and it definitely, I think, is a sipper.
Yeah.
Sure. Yeah, this is definitely not something you're going to have a few, you know, sitting around with your buddies at the bar. This is definitely something for home, you know, just sipping light, taking your time, you know.
That's right. Not a beer to drink at the game.
No. Definitely not.
Yeah.
And there is a little bitterness, like a little hot presence.
It seems a little bitter, yeah.
You know, for a barley wine, usually you have that, like rotten fruit sweetness.
Yeah.
But
it's got a little bitterness to it.
Cool. All right, so we'll let this warm up, we'll finish them up, and we'll be back with our final thoughts in just a moment.
Welcome back, everybody. So we've let it sit a little bit, and now what do we think, gents?
When you first smell it, I was kind of off put by it just because it seemed like it was really strong in alcohol, and obviously 9.5 it is, but that it tastes completely different to me than it smells, and that's not a bad thing. Like, I think it's easy to drink. I think it's not overburdened with alcohol. Definitely lots of flavor inside of it, but it's good. I've never had a barley wine before, so it's definitely something new, but I liked it.
Yeah, I agree with you. You know, usually the higher alcohol content beers are not my favorites because it has that, the taste of alcohol, and when you smell it, you can smell, you know, it smells more like alcohol than
like
beer.
It's overpowering
the
beer.
And it overpowers you, and sometimes the taste overpowers you. This one's not, it doesn't have that overpowering taste, even though you smell it a little, you know, so.
Yeah. I don't really drink barley wines often, but I think I would seek this one out, you know, again. I think they did a great job with it. It's that back end to it. It's not as clingy. It's not as powerful. It has a nice kind of lightness to it for a barley wine, which, you know, this is kind of my style. So this is kind of, I enjoyed it. It's good.
For a first time barley wine drinker myself, I would definitely try it again.
Yeah.
I enjoy it. I like it. Cool. It definitely would be, you know, a one-off kind of scenario where you're just sitting back watching the game at home and you want to sit with it for, you know, a couple innings or a couple periods, but I would definitely try it again.
It's a good, it's a good sharing beer.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Right. Someone that's else right. And take your time with it and enjoy it, celebrate it, you know, like wine, right?
Exactly.
Yep. Absolutely.
Exactly.
Okay, again, this was the 1871 Barley Wine by Dark City Brewing Company. Their brewery's in Asbury Park, and they have various visiting hours from Thursday through Sunday. It can be found at a variety of liquor stores throughout the state, Roger Wilco in Ventnor, Gary's Wine and Liquor in both Bernardsville and Hillsboro, and right now it's available on tap at Legends Ale House in Sukasana. And to see the full availability and learn more about this brewer and this brewing company, there's a box right there. You click on that, and bam. There you have it.
All right. Thanks so much for watching episode 6 of the New Jersey Craft Beer Review. For Frank Serto, Dan Tantillo, Chris Anucci, and myself, Chris Swenman, thanks for watching. Cheers.
Cheers.